welcome to Weddings Unplugged. This is my beautiful bridal panel, and today we're discussing budgeting. So in planning any event, you have to think about what your budget is going to be and how much you want to spend. One of the things I saw upon research was looking at pretty much determining what type of wedding you want to have, and that will dictate how much money you're going to spend, whether it's a backyard wedding, a wedding in a ballroom. You know, you really have to like think about that to see how much money you're going to spend. Another thing that you have to take into consideration with budgeting is coming together, really talking to your partner about how much money you're going to spend. Yes. And also what's non-negotiable. Like for me, my photographer and my videographer, non-negotiable. Mm-hmm. That is very important to me. And then the venue, that's also very important to me. Everything else, you know, kind of like, they'll fit in where they fit in, but those are the top three things that are important to me. What about for you ladies? What was non-negotiable in your budgeting?
Oh man, I think videographer and photographer initially were, and then I started realizing that I was, the most important thing to me was that I got to enjoy it in the moment. So I cared about videographer and photographer, but like immediately I was like, wait a minute, I want to make sure I have this in my reception. Like I want to make sure that we actually get to enjoy it, that it's memorable. So I started learning like, wait a minute, it's the DJ. Like I want to pick my DJ. I want this person to be the DJ. That became important. And then honestly on the opposite end, probably the least important was food.
Whoa.
Just because I know I can find somebody that makes good food, but you know, the goal of my wedding is not to make sure everybody leaves full. And unless you have disgusting food, chances are that's not what people are going to be talking about. People remember that they danced, that they had it, you know, that they enjoyed it. So I think it turned out to be like the way that my reception was run turned out to be my like, this has to be the way I want it.
So I think for me, the top three that I'm thinking about right now, the opposite of you, I think food is one of the top things. I feel like a lot of people spend so much money on food and they don't enjoy it. It doesn't taste good. So I'm just hoping my fiance and I will have some time and just at least sit and eat some of the food that we're paying so much money for.
You probably won't.
You can and you will.
Oh,
I get it. You can do it.
He gets hangry, so we need to make sure
he does.
But also another non-negotiable, I think, would be the DJ. Because I know going to like weddings, stuff like that, you want to have that great experience dancing. You want people to have a good time because people are spending this money trying to spend time with you. You want to make sure people are good.
And
the ceremony. Yes, of course.
The DJ during the ceremony can make or break the way it flows.
Right. Yeah.
Definitely. What about you? I think food, specifically because that's how we started, you know, kind of just getting our budget together. We know, you know, you're not going to spend, go all out on everything. So what were your three most important things and what were mine? So him, it was definitely food, and especially food that reflected who we are. Because, you know, people know what I eat. So imagine bringing them to a wedding, we're eating boiled chicken. And so it's like you really want it to be a reflection of you. It's a part of the event.
Right.
And you want people to feel good, like you want them to be happy. I mean,
that's
food
true.
Makes me happy.
That's true, because for he and I, we're both Haitian, and a lot of the venues,
good
you
food.
Have to use their caterer. And I was like, well, I kind of want to eat Haitian food.
Right.
So then you have to find a venue that's not you're not gonna be trying on no Haitian food. You will not.
We have our new griots.
No, so I guess that will be very important. I guess another thing is that when you're looking at your budget, what's important to you and who would allow you to do what's important for you.
Right.
Because some of these venues, you won't be able to maybe bring your own DJ. They might have a DJ on staff. Some of them you can't bring in your own caterer. So it's like, okay, what's important to me? And then find the venue that fits what's important to me to make sure I have a really good day.
What do you guys think about like negotiating prices?
I did. With my florist, girl, we went back and forth a good 2 months. That's why I started early, because I was like, well, how about this? And, you know, I wanted a lot of palm features, like unique palm features. So she was like, oh, that's harder to find, so it's more expensive. I was like, well, we live in Miami.
Right.
Palm tree here, it's a palm tree there. We can make it work. So, you know, they were very helpful. And in the end of the day, a lot of these vendors, they do want your business. And then right. for me personally, I know it was important for me to support small businesses.
And
minority businesses, yeah. women, just being really mindful of where my dollar was going mm-hmm. and where mm-hmm. our dollar, like as a yes. couple, was going.
I'm glad you brought that. I was the same way. All of my vendors were Black vendors, and that was very, very, very important for me, except the actual venue itself.
Yeah.
But I searched high and low.
Yeah.
I searched high and low. So if y'all know any Black vendors, but I mean, it's I could still have like a baby shower later or something. But yeah, it was just very important for me, and also just calling around like and not taking mm-hmm. one answer for
right.
the go, because
right.
as soon as you say wedding.
Don't say it. Yeah. We have
as
an
soon
event.
As you say wedding. Right. So yeah, that was big for me, negotiating, calling people.
Well, thank you for joining us on this episode of Weddings Unplugged. See you next time.